I think, yeah, again, we're in education, so this is a big drive, particularly in the UK now that they're bringing very fee-based places at university. There's a big drive to think about what's the value of being in university learning graphic design or visual communication. We use those terms interchangeably, so forgive me if I move between the two. So, and I think one of the stories that people have been thinking about is what is a wide and wide paintings require large fees. If all we're doing is learning how to use software and sort of develop a visual acuity. And I think increasingly the point of difference that's becoming clear is that an underpinning of research within visual communication and design is really the critical difference between the university type education and something you might pick up at that sort of college level where you sort of frame things around software. So this is our first part beyond the logo, because I think part of this, we did move it on site, but we sort of, you know, in good design and style, we came back to this original concept, which is, after a long conversation, I just moved to back to the UK from this evening. I was working in January over the last 8 to 10 years. So we sort of had this conversation over Skype around the role of the designer, the shifting role of the designer into this more sort of problematized environment where we no longer also preparing people for the difficult student experience when people leave the university. It's a much more complex space. And again, this idea that the role of the designer is shifting from somebody that is a necessarily problem solver, but also maybe now becoming somebody that asks questions. The classic notion is, we respond to a given brief or given scenario. And what we were finding is that now we were trying to kind of embed visual communication design into complex sort of wicked problems where the visual communicator is part of a sort of a social issue and can bring the skill of the visual communication design to that conversation. One way of doing that is this idea of putting the visual communication designer and their practice into a research agenda at the front end, rather than this idea of receiving a brief, receiving the problem, and then somehow aestheticizing that, somehow responding with the, you know, with the research logo in its crudest terms, and with this sort of communication collateral, which classically is, you know, often the case where you, that's where the design is often being brought in. So again, this Jennifer's going to take us, be quiet in a second, Jennifer's going to take us through a rather nice case study of how a visual communication designer and set designers has been embedded in a transdisciplinary research group. And part of that issue is being part of the group, and this has come up today quite a lot, I think, is designers don't design in isolation, they design around people and about ability to work within a group. And hopefully this will come out with some of the examples we're going to see in a second. So we're doing a bit of double activity. The other thing that I think is very curious is the last few years we've seen this rise in this term design thinking, which is normally used by, not by designers, but by economists and people that are trying to improve their market share in one thing or another. And when we do see design coming into research, it's often at this level, the sort of, you know, I wish I'd mentioned post-it notes a long time ago, because, you know, the world doesn't seem to be able to exist without the post-it note. And I think what we're going to be advocating here again is this, when design is in a research context, it needs to go beyond this stage. I think it's a very useful part of the conversation. But what we're going to advocate is that there's a legitimacy in deep knowledge of visual communication, the typologies that we use need to be applied to these complex issues, by doing that, shift the way that people understand what's within the issue. So again, when we do this example code, you can see how, you know, the code use of animation, interaction design, typography, all the sort of typologies that we teach, and we still, you know, we still need to be able to make sure that students have photographs and have the finest things. They all bring a granularity and insight, a way of looking at a research issue. And in themselves, again, it's the idea that this speculation through design is a really worthy thing to do, and in itself is a product. It's not necessarily about the end sort of solution, it's about problematizing the issue, allowing people some sort of view, some sort of opinion around what was being discussed. And I think this is, again, sort of moving towards a maybe in a more sort of social science, Christopher Frey's sort of version of art as research. The speculative is a place that we can evaluate things. It's not necessarily a scientific paradigm where things are proven through statistical change. I think there is value in speculative in terms of creative form. And then again, see that in the examples we're going to see. Okay, so I'm going to sort of wrap up there, and I'll come back at the end and sort of join in some questions that may be some really points. But the interesting bit is going to link to Jennifer, and she did the hard work. And you're going to introduce the project.
I will. But I'll actually just, if I may, go back to this slide. And this was pivotal in a project that I'm going to talk about. Because this is a term I actually hadn't come across before. I started with this project, Fuzzy Frontier, what is that? And it really was this indeterminate space where exploration can take place. Normally it's used by product engineers and in developing products. In this particular project I'm going to introduce to, it was really all the partners in the project, including visual communication design, to be part of an exploratory space. So we've defined it as an exploratory open-ended space where the solution is suspended. We're not looking, not deriving towards that, but it's an open space to find the questions, to find the right questions. You can find questions, but you must find the right questions. You